Hi, this is Ike from Groovy Entertainment. Today we got another book on tape to play for you. Today's book is Batman and Robin, The Case of the Laughing Sphinx, Part 2 from 1980. So let's get started.
Tonight, we'll need our whirly bats to see what's going on.
Flying high over the park, the dynamic duo noticed nothing unusual until Robin spotted a mob of people running in fear from the Tunnel of Love.
Something's up!
Robin shouted to Batman.
People don't run out of the Tunnel of Love unless there's something terribly wrong inside. Let's go down and investigate.
Cause of that panic, chum.
When the whirly bats landed, the caped crusaders leaped aboard one of the boats that floated through the Tunnel of Love. As the two crime fighters drifted into the ominous cavern, they could see only a dim light coming from far inside. The boy wonder shivered, but quickly overcame his fear and rode with the Batman down the peaceful stream that led to almost certain danger. Inside the tunnel, the masked detectives saw what had caused all the fun lovers to flee the peaceful amusement park ride in panic. Along the walls of the tunnel, someone had placed lifelike statues of creatures horrible enough to frighten even the bravest adventurer. Frankenstein, Dracula, the Wolfman, and the Mummy all were leaning menacingly over the small boat as the Batman and Robin floated through the tunnel. It was a nightmare, but this couldn't be real, Robin thought. Then suddenly, one of the monsters moved.
Batman! Those monsters, they're alive!
Robin shouted his warning to the Batman just as the monsters began to jump into the boat. Each monster had a look of hate in his eyes. All of them wanted to destroy the dynamic duo.
Batman, we're sitting ducks!
Not if we fight back. It may be 6 against 2, but remember, they're only human. That takes care of 2 of them, Robin. We're doing just fine.
Tackling this mummy isn't easy, but I'll have him tied up in a second. I hope you know how to swim, you reject from a horror show.
Save the joking for later, Robin. This is serious business.
This is no joke, Batman. That mummy short-circuited when he hit the water. These monsters aren't human. They're robots. And I think I know how to stop them. Just push them in the water.
Within moments, all that was left of the monsters were sputtering ripples in the calm water. The dark tunnel was lit brightly by the sparks of the beaten robots.
This type of sick humor has to be the Joker's work,
Batman said. From the corner of his eye, Robin spotted a thin figure heading for the tunnel exit.
I think you're right, Batman,
Robin said.
And there he goes! Let's get him!
Batman and Robin raced out of the tunnel, but it was already too late. By the time the two crime fighters got to the exit, the Joker was gone. But he left a clue. Robin spotted it first.
Look! Floating in the water! It's a giant Joker playing card! I'll fish it out. Maybe it can give us a lead in this case.
Hmm. yet another mysterious riddle. Robin read it aloud to Batman.
The man you seek is both here and there. For on this night, he'll be on the air.
The Caped Crusader thought for a long moment after hearing the latest clue. He finally said,
"We're getting closer to the solution. I can feel it. But we still need more answers."
Suddenly, the Batman realized what he had to do next.
"Come on, Robin, to the Batmobile. We're going to the Gotham City Zoo to pay the Catwoman a little visit."
At the Gotham City Zoo, all was silent, except for the footsteps of the dynamic duo as they ran towards the lion house. When they arrived there, they found the outside cage empty. The lions were probably inside sleeping, Robin thought. But the door of the outside cage was open. Inside the cage was a lion tamer's chair and a bullwhip. On the chair was a large sheet of paper with a riddle written in a now familiar handwriting. Batman and Robin walked inside the cage to inspect the clue. Robin read it aloud.
"To find the man who's causing you grief, turn on the tube and get some relief." "What does it mean, Batman?"
Robin asked.
"Just a moment, Robin. All the clues are starting to fit into place. Let me see."
As the dynamic duo thought about their latest clue, they did not notice the Catwoman quietly slinking up behind them. Quickly, she grabbed the cage door and slammed it shut with a loud clang. The Batman and Robin were caught totally by surprise.
This is perfect.
The Catwoman gloated.
"The famous Batman and Robin, behind bars at last."
Batman pulled and tugged at the cage bars, but they would not budge. He and the Boy Wonder were trapped.
"I've got a little friend of mine waiting on the other side of those bars behind you."
The Catwoman purred.
"I'm afraid he missed his supper last night, so you can imagine how much he's dying to meet. Or is that eat, you two? I do hope you all get to know each other very well. Ta-ta, dynamic dumbos."
The Catwoman said as she crept back into the darkness. Slowly, the cage door behind the dynamic duo opened. And then, out of the darkness jumped a gigantic, ferocious lion. Eyes ablaze, fangs and claws exposed, the hungry king of the jungle sprang at the startled Batman. Never before had the Dark Knight detective faced such a savage opponent. The Batman was stunned, and although he tried to move out of the lion's path, the starving beast was too fast. In seconds, it was upon him, scratching and clawing at the Batman's costume.
"Robin, I'm pinned down. Can't move. Can't get to my utility belt."
"Hang on, Batman. I'll get the situation under control."
Like an experienced trainer, Robin grabbed the whip and began cracking it behind the lion. Then he gently pushed the chair against the lion's back. Angered by this interruption, the lion turned to battle the brave Boy Wonder, leaving the Batman behind. Free to use his hands once again, Batman reached into his utility belt and tossed a sleeping gas capsule at the ferocious lion, just as it was about to pounce upon the Boy Wonder. Immediately, the big cat fell into a deep, peaceful sleep. Robin cautiously stepped over the sleeping beast to aid the Batman as he picked the lock on the other side of the now quiet cage.
"Thanks, Robin,"
Batman said.
"You saved my life."
"No problem, Batman,"
Robin answered, smiling.
"If you hadn't used that gas capsule when you did, I might have turned out to be dessert for our slumbering friend here."
Once outside the cage, Batman returned to the task of fitting all the different clues together.
"The first clue mentioned a game. One that awarded prizes and fame for the correct responses. The clue at the Ice Cube Factory said that one player doesn't know the other's identity until the game is over. The Joker's clue said that the man we're looking for would be on the air tonight. That means television or radio. But the last clue mentioned tube, which means TV. So when you put all the clues together, they tell us that Frederick Smythe is going to be on a TV game show tonight.
Robin snapped his fingers. He knew the solution.
And the only TV game show where contestants try to figure out people's occupations is... What's my job? Quick, Batman! To the television studio!
Turns out to be none other than Ladies and gentlemen, it's time for the highlight of our show. Let's crack open the eggs of the Laughing Sphinx.
The studio audience was horrified, shocked. They sat glued to their seats, but each viewer hoped someone or something would put an end to the villain's evil plan. Meanwhile, the villains gloated as they prepared to smash the eggs.
I must admit, Joker old buddy, your suggestion that we team up was superb! Yes, Joker! But why did we have to go through all this TV stuff?
Yeah, what difference does it make to you? I enjoy a little media coverage every now and then.
As if in answer to the audience's silent prayers, the dynamic duo suddenly swept into view. Now the four newly teamed villains were shocked and could only stare up in disbelief as the caped crusaders were thwarting their evil scheme.
I thought you got rid of them,
said the Joker.
And I thought you did,
answered the villain.
I thought I finished them all,
said the cat.
What does it matter?
Groaned the Riddler.
We're all done for.
Swept by the four arguing friends, plucking up the Sphinx and its eggs as he passed.
Sorry, I've got to run, fellas!
He shouted down at the flabbergasted villains.
But I've got to take my Sphinx for a walk!
Meanwhile, near the ceiling of the television studio, Batman was planning the final downfall of the evil team. Seconds after the boy wonder made his television debut, Batman cut loose the final cable holding up the huge What's My Job sign. With a tremendous thud, the sign crashed down around the villainous crew. The audience went wild.
Give him one for me!
Ominous Grunt!
Not him, Marshall!
Soon, the entire audience was chanting, Batman, Batman! As Batman swung down to the stage on his Batrobe, the audience rose to give him a standing ovation. Then Robin returned to toss a final batarang around the four beaten evildoers. Batman smiled and waved at the cheering crowd. He was not used to being a television star, but he accepted the audience's cheers and applause graciously.
Is everything okay?
He whispered to Robin.
Everything's fine, Batman.
Robin answered, grinning.
I untied Smythe, and he led me to the rest of the crew. They were locked up backstage. The Sphinx is in safe hands once again.
Crazy team-up ideas, Joker! That goes double for me!
After the show was over, Commissioner Gordon arrived with the police to take away the four criminals. Gordon was anxious to congratulate the Caped Crusaders.
I got to the studio as soon as I could, but it looks like you fellas beat me to the punch.
You might say that.
Robin smiled.
Well,
Gordon answered.
It was a great show, Dynamic Duo. I saw it all on TV, along with millions of other viewers. Gotham City will sleep safely tonight because of you two.
Phew,
Robin said.
What a job!
It's all in a night's work,
Batman answered.
You know, we did three things tonight, Robin. We rescued Frederick Smythe, and we saved the Laughing Sphinx from the clutches of four of our deadliest foes.
What's the third thing?
Robin asked.
Well,
Batman answered, a grin appearing on his face.
We probably made What's My Job the most popular game show in television history.
Oh, brother!
Robin groaned.
Let's go home, Batman!
Robin, you just read my mind.
I So that was Batman and Robin, The Case of the Laughing Sphinx, Part 2 from 1982. So if you like, subscribe, share, and comment, and have a groovy day. And our next book will be... You're the Greatest, Charlie Brown.